I mean, it's a soul-crushing experience we are currently facing. You have everything, but you can't do anything. The most disheartening thing is we have the knowledge, we have the power, we have the resources, but still being helpless at this point of time, no, not to get or help them with a simple bed or an oxygen. I mean, this is the most helpless time to be around. We could not get a bed for our own loved ones.
One lady came in. I don't know her. She was a young lady. She said, "Can I talk to you, doctor?" I said, "Yes." So she's like, "My husband is COVID positive, and I need a bed. Ma'am, can you please help me out and give me a bed?" So, and I knew that her husband's saturation was dropping, and she was just trying everywhere to get a bed. So I just had to tell her that, I can't really help her. I think that was very heart-wrenching for me because there was no way I could help her. We are not able to give the care to the patients as we would like to, and especially just telling them that we don't have the resources to admit them or to care for them because of a lack of bed. We are short with medical staff. We just feel helpless seeing all the relatives and people dying, even though especially those patients who we could save them, and not being able to just because of lack of infrastructure. That's makes you really bad. I can't describe the emotions, but it's a very hopeless situation that you face.
Each hospital bed is now having a wait list of around 75 patients waiting to get a bed. That is the reality for the past 2-3 weeks all across India. In most hospitals across India, hospital beds are full. So this wave two is different because the crisis is for oxygen bed. Patients turning up to hospital late. These are really fueling the numbers. And with simple oxygenation, most of them are improving. It is not the COVID that is killing us. It is a lack of these basic essentials, allowing them for timely oxygen and supplementing them with oxygen. That is actually, fueling the crisis for us at this point of time.
Even in a private hospital, we are running short of just by hour to hour, we are having to conserve oxygen, and just at the nick of time, we are getting oxygen. In the government hospital, the doctors are really running short of resources because they cannot refuse any patients. So the patients are just lying on the veranda or whatever. They bring their own oxygen and waiting in the queue. One of the patient's father, who was sick with COVID, and it was diagnosed already, and the patient needed ICU care, but because of bed being all full, he was getting treatment in the emergency care for almost 2 to 3 days. The doctors in the emergency department explained to the daughter that your father needs an ICU care, and we don't have the facility to revive him in case he collapses here. She did not have any other way of going to any other hospital, so she just stuck on to that emergency care, and she spent almost I think close to 3 days in the emergency. And of course, after 3 days, she did manage to get the father into the ICU care, but by a better time, I think it was too late. I mean, her father is still there in the ICU. He's very critical. It's just left to the family themselves how they get a bed. Like, it's up to them how much they can run around, go around the city to get a hospital bed, because you cannot book it over the phone. Because it's just, if you are lucky, if you get into that slot and somebody in the ICU, it sounds very cruel, but either a patient is discharged or somebody who has died, if that bed is empty and you are there at that time requiring the most care, then you will get in.
This disease has mostly affected the urban cities predominantly, and that's where the news is also highlighting. The disease has started spreading in the rural India. We are getting alarmed cases from other parts of rural India, especially UP, Bihar, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. So once they reach for healthcare, I mean, that's where the real, crisis is. I mean, we don't have hospitals, doctors, nurses. We have only traditional healers and PHC medical officers with no facilities. There are so many things at stake once it hits the rural India. New Zealand support to World Vision, and World Vision investing in these 115 districts is going to make our system ready in terms of oxygen concentrators, in terms of beds, in terms of an ambulance services, in terms of medical devices, which can save life, is going to be well prepared in terms of handling this when it really hits in the rural India, which we are already seeing numbers.
Every time I go to the hospital, of course, you are scared of carrying the infection back home, especially because I have two small children. Once you're in the hospital, you forget about the fear because you see the patients, how they're suffering, and you see so much pain and distress all around.